Hello internet again. I am here again to do another F-sharp video using the exercism.io exercises. This next one is based on the 12 days of Christmas. If you don't know the 12 days of Christmas, it is a Christmas song where about 12 days, so 12 verses each. Well, you can read the text here if you're interested in the song. Not quite sure what it wants yet. Try to capture the structure of the song in your code. Well, that's just a little hint nice to have. And I think we need to output the lyrics of the song 12 Days of Christmas. Of course, we could just type it exactly like that, but if you look at this, on the first day of Christmas my true love gave to me, and then the gift, a partridge in a pear tree. On the second day you've got two of something, and then and a partridge in a pear tree. The second you've got three, the item, and then you repeat the second and the first, and that carries on. Four calling birds for the fourth one. 3, 2, 1. Let's hit the tests, see what they look like. It just expects exactly that. If we say 1, 1 should equal 1, 1. I'm assuming that is the verse to start with. Let's head down a little to try and see 1, 3 verse, from verse 1 to verse 3. Okay, I see. From 4 to 6, from 1 to 12 will print out the entire song in an array, it seems. Nice. Equal expected is just an array, a string array. Fairly simple. Let me get a terminal open. I should have done that already. .NET watch test. It fails. That makes sense. Start, stop. Cool. I don't know if F-sharp has this, but in TypeScript I would be able to say something like day is 1 or 2 or 3 or 4. Is that a thing here? And then I can say start is of type day. This doesn't seem to be valid. I am not really familiar with defining types in F sharp. It's not something I've had to do. I know I don't have to do it here. I just think it's nice. I'm just going to look that up quickly and see if I can find anything on it. Type A equals int, so I could say day. Equals int. Google F sharp type int in range. Say one, what happens? It doesn't like that. What if I tell it it's an int one? No. Okay, alas, the F-sharp type system doesn't provide a way to define a subtype range. That is a type representing some subset. Okay, so that seemed to be a bit of a maybe pointless endeavor. There might be ways of programming some sort of check in, but let me not bother too much. So I'm going to just say each of these are an int. Just because I want my types static for now, and let's say we will return a string sequence. I think that is the correct syntax. It's not going to work. Of course, what we want to do, the theory of doing this test-driven development, is to return the minimum amount of code that will allow the test to pass, which of course is that. Okay, we've got a list, so let's say we want to return a string list. Got lots of squigglies here. Namespace fs unit is not defined. Doesn't seem to be having trouble running though, and my test does pass. That's what this is all about. Next test is day two. I do wrong. I broke something here. Unexpected double semicolon. I don't see a double semicolon. Line 7, position 9. Nope, I definitely don't have a double semicolon there. Something has broken. F sharp interactive. Oh, that's not my test. Here we go. My test has failed, of course. So I need to now return on the second day of Christmas. So what needs to change? This needs to change to second. What's a nice way of doing that? And that is going to, of course, be based on that number. So we could create something called days, which will be first. Sorry, I have been programming JavaScript and TypeScript a lot recently. Days first and second. Let gifts equals a partridge in a pear tree and two turtle doves. I No, it needs more, but I want to see if this idea works before I flesh it out too much, or else I'm putting in code that might end up getting deleted. So I just want enough to work for now. Then we want to say almost repeat for each a range of one. So and we would want to say on the day's day sorry, I'm thinking in different languages here, aren't I? On the second or first day of Christmas. Let's copy that. And then, of course, a we want to for each. Okay, so we now need can we sec range? No, list range. No, how would we do a for each? Let's see. We want to range down. So we want to start with day minus one. And it looks like two dots, zero. That can be mapped to gifts X we want to map that into to do string join is maybe it's system string join but we need to what are we joining on? We want a comma space, don't we? These all have spaces. Let me add a space that might make this a little easier. No, I'm not going to add space there because I can join on comma space and add a space there. And that, I've got no idea if that is anything near valid. Well, it lets me let it. And now, okay, we're just working on one line, so all I'm going to worry about is start for now. So I will return songline start. Doesn't like this because it should be an array. Okay, well, my code is valid. It's not very neat, but it compiles. Well, it seems to compile. It's running. The test does not pass. Match exception was thrown. Expected that. I got on the second day of Christmas. My true love gave to me. And that seemed to be all. Yeah. I'm ranging from 0 to 0. No. Yes, yeah, day. Let's say day to 0. Or day to 1. Let's see what that does. So we're getting the turtle doves now. But this is the first day, so we have an off by one error. I'm actually thinking of, is it cheating if I do that? Basically shifting my arrays up so that we match. So 1 is 1, 2 is 2. Still not passing. We did not end with a full stop. Not that that helped. Okay, on the second day of Christmas, my true love gave to me. Second day is not working. Why is that? Maybe ranges down don't work. Let's try as an experiment. I am going to make the assumption that that is going to reverse the sequence. Okay, another thing that is missing is the word and. You see here, we said we're listing in comma, comma, comma. But here we've got comma and. So on the last one, we need the comma and. And that would be here. Which would basically be if X is 1 and day is greater than 1, then and else nothing plus that. Why does it not like my if? Maybe I should bracket this. Okay, it doesn't like the and. Maybe that's not. Okay. This is still not working. What trouble do we have? Ah, it's just okay, I see here. We need to wrap that up. Okay, finally, it works. Let's add the third day. I'm not going to worry about running, then fixing. I'm just going to put the code I think will be needed in, which will be this. Then skipping the third test, running that, and if this works, I'm going to look at how this can be tidied up a little bit. Okay, third test passes, but this code is not very nice. Going to move these out of here for now. I might put them back. Doesn't matter too much where they get defined. The one nice thing, well, one of the reasons I like to keep it in the function is it sort of encapsulates the scope of that. It doesn't make it a public variable. It makes it private in a sense. But I can always throw those things back in there just now. One thing, let's tidy this up. So what that does is that creates a that's the gift part of the day. So let's create a function and call it, let's call it my true love gave to me. Don't have to be that. Let's say my love gave to me. Still don't like it too much. So we've got the range that gets reversed. That gets mapped to that ugly thing. And that gets joined in a string. I'm going to check to see if F-sharp has anything specific on string concatenation. Before I do that, I am going to say my love gave to me day because I want to run this and make sure that me moving things around has not broken anything. I want to do that while moving things around. I know it takes a bit of time, but then if something does break, I know what change broke that. Okay, let's try something I saw now. I don't know if it's going to work, but it was string.concat. What my joining value is. Nice, that's a bit neater. Okay, now this thing. Maybe I break this up. Let I'm going to say and gift. I know it's not the most eloquent way of naming something, but okay, but I need two values. This is, let's call this the gift number. And we will be returning a function with the day, because I need both of those. Then I can do my if. If gift is equal to 1. I think I need to swap these around. You'll see why now. Gift equals 1 and day greater than 1, then I know it might be a little bit of repetition, but I think I'm going to do that. Else that. I find that a little neater. Now, if I say and gift, and it's two functions now, so the first function wants day, and the second wants x. But because it's like that, I should be able to remove that and remove that, and of course it doesn't work. Maybe I just can't return a function straight. What if I say let inner equals return inner? No, there we go. I am very okay. Let's see. There's a problem. Gifts for gift. I'm gonna change that to just I. index. Can be my gift index. It still doesn't like that. This construct may only be written int to string. What if I say I'm going to return an int to string? Inner is an int to string, but it doesn't like it. I'm gonna try and move it out. Still doesn't like it. That's very peculiar. I'm a little lost. I'm going to strip this down a little and just go straight. Okay, I'm going to take some time and figure this out and then come back. Okay, so I am a bit of an idiot. F sharp doesn't use a return, it just returns it. Back to the if. Doesn't look like that can be done straight, which is a bit pity. Maybe I was saying return. Let me just get this to build. That's fine. If I do take that out, doesn't like it. This expression was expected to have that, but has a bool. It's actually doing a comparison there. What if we say fun? That could work, I suppose. Okay, that is working again. So we have a function called my true love gave to me, which is going to basically spit out the list of gifts received on that day. Then we've got a function. I'm going to change it from songline to on the, and that'll be the day line. I want to remove that, put that there. So I've got on the that plus my true love gave to me. So that it becomes readable in that sense. It is all running. That looks a bit better. 2, I think. I'm going to bring this back in. I don't know why I took it out, to be completely honest. If this is still working. That is okay. I'm going to get through a few more. So we want the fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, the 8th, the 9th, the 10th. That's it. On this side, I'm going to do some copy paste. Four calling birds. Geese are laying, which means by the time this gift arrives, you might have a lot more than 6 gifts, geese. Seven swans are swimming. Eight maids are milking. Okay, of course it's now running just up until the third test, which should still be fine. I am going to unblock some more to make sure I'm still on track, but just the ones where we've got the same number, 8, 8, 9, 9, 10, 10, because it is after that things are going to change. 12, 12. Run. Nope. There's always something I do wrong. Okay, so we've got a problem on the fifth day where my true love gave to me 5 golden rings, 4 calling birds, 3 French hens, 2 turtle doves, and a partridge in a pear tree. Where is the difference? What I can do is copy that, put it there. Remove the extra there we go. We might have this problem in other places as well. Maybe I should go around and preemptively look for it. Of course, this isn't going to build with this there. Nine looks like it might be a problem. Length. Twelfth looks like it might be a problem. Twelfth. Do you have that in Windows 10? Copy, Control C doesn't always copy what you think it's going to copy. This is happening to me more and more frequently. Back in my day, Control C just used to copy what you had selected. Okay, everything is working. Going to undo this one, and it will not work because it wants three lines. You see here, we want to recite line 1, 2, 3. So what we should be able to do is say start to end. Into stop, not end. Why does it have a problem with this? It should be a map, that's why. Sec.map. Cannot figure out list. Maybe it wants a list map. There we go. Silly me, silly me. Okay, that works. I'm going to remove some more. Saying 15 past, all 15. This doesn't look like the song, which was something they asked, and I'm not sure exactly how one would get there. I've got the Onde, My True Love. One way would be something like, on the first what if we actually said first, made a variable called first. Something like that. I'm not quite sure how that. I suppose you could then pipe in something like that, Partridge. So how would that work? I know we've got this working. But I just want to think about this for a little bit. And it will also have to be in an array. But we could start with just the first test again. We need a variable called first. So what is first? Is first a type? Or is first equals first? But what if first is a tuple? There's one way of doing it, but we want something called a partridge. So first is equal to first. And let partridge equal to, I'm going to copy this below. That not work in F sharp. seem to learn something new every day. Then, what does that do? On the first day, so we need something called on the, it's going to take a day, and that's going to return the string "Let my true love gave to me." What are we doing with this? We first want to take in a gift. Again, we're going to be returning a function. Let's call it inner for now until we can find something better to maybe name it. And we're going to return inner. This is a string, so this is let's call it on the. So that means that the result of that can be piped into that. But there. But it doesn't like this. What if we do that? Now, this gift is a partridge in a pear tree. So, OT is on the "my true love gave to me," but we want to say on the "my true love gave to me." I'm going to put this up here. And of course, the gift and a full stop. Doesn't like partridge here. The expression. partridge is a string, and I should be doing that. The expression was expected to have string to A. But I thought how that worked was not like that. Let's be explicit. Gift is a string. And let's say fun OT is that. Ah, look at that. Always, if you look, you find what might be wrong. I have just commented these out very lazily, but get the point. I don't know if they're all not working, or just the one, so I did that again. I just want to see if I'm on a somewhat right track with just at least the first one, and that is fine. But I want of Christmas. I don't know why, I just think it would be cool, but what could we do with that? I could just return itself, or OT can be equal to OT plus day of Christmas my true love gave to me. That does pass. Can you type first equals first? Probably not. I'm going to move these out because why not? And let me grab these. Little tedious. Okay. Now, these. I'm just going to call that birds. I know they're all birds. Going to do that. F sharp doesn't like it, but so what? No formatter for F sharp, nice. Get rid of all of these. Okay, so let recite equals. Then we want the whole song. Starting with the blank again. What have I done wrong here? Equals missing here. Ah, mustn't use the word return. For the second test, I now want to say doves, which means this needs to be take a parameter array, which I have no idea how to do in F sharp. So I'm going to look that up. F sharp param array. Okay, so what I have found, let's see if this works. If we say no, that should be a string. Why is doesn't seem to like param array open system. Gift to string concat with comma. Okay, this is not going to help with the and, but we will worry about that just now. Still not happy here. Attributes are not permitted on let bindings. What does that mean? Maybe it means it has to be a proper function. Well, if that's an array, we could always just do that, but I would like to know how to do it. Must be possible to do a parameter array. Everything does seem to point to that. It doesn't like that. What if I, huh? Everything seems to really point to that, but it doesn't like that. I'm going to see if the tests run. Attributes are not permitted. What if we pull that out? Okay. So maybe we want to take those outside. That still doesn't work. Full name, 12days.doves. It does not like this. That dot doing there. Expression was expected to have string array, but it has string. But I thought that is what the point of. Param arrays was. It's param array thing not working. Maybe it's just not a very well working F sharp something. Okay, I don't know. Let's see what we can do like that. This is why I'm learning it. See if we put it. back. I can't figure out what this param array is supposed to be doing. Okay, the test's failing, but it is building, which is what I'm concerned about. Now I know it's failing because if we do that, it should pass. Well, the first one should pass, the second one will still fail. What I want to have is basically this. I'm just going to do a bunch, don't know how many. Then we can start changing. Then all the gifts. Drummers, pipers, lords, ladies, maids, swans. Five golden rings. Birds, hens, doves. Something's gone out of sequence here. And a partridge in a pear tree. Let's see where we're missing. 12 drummers, pipers, lords, ladies, maidens, swans. Geese, golden rings. Birds, hens, turtle doves, and a partridge in a pear tree. That should almost satisfy this last test, but we've got the problem of the and again. In changing this code around, I reintroduced that. So this needs that into account. How did I do it the last time? Okay, now we don't know. What if we actually just created a function called and? Really make it that simple. End is a reserved word. What if we just said ND? I don't need that, which means if I don't have that, I can also put these back into my function. All three tests are failing. What a surprise. I know 1 and 2 should fail. From what I could see, 12 should be passable. But it is clearly not. Where have we gone wrong? Expected. And what did we get? Line one seems okay. So, where is this going wrong? Okay, let's not worry about that just yet. Let's maybe do this line by line, but I want to filter. I don't know if I could put an if in here, or what if I just made this as simple as a tuple? Oh, look at that. That could be my problem. Now, of course, that's not going to work, so that has to get cleaned up. So, what do we want to do? We want to say where wants a list. Two passed, one failed. Okay, so I'm going to comment that out quickly and do all these single lines. That might give me an idea if any line is broken. Eight pass, so we've got a few broken lines. Let's see where we start. Day 11. Let's go and compare the actual and the expected. So first is actual or expected, and then actual I've got two turtle doves instead of and a partridge. Nine passed, three failed. Seven and eight failed. Okay, but if seven fails, then eight will fail possibly because it's got part of it in it. Let's do this again. I think this is just the easiest way to find where a problem's coming in. This and again. Let me actually look through a few, see if there are any others. Okay. One still failing. And it seems to be on day 12. Before I do that, let me just go and check you out. I should have just gone to look there right away. Okay, something I want to do. The squigglies bother me a little. So I want to get these all the same. I know it's not proper to start with an underscore like that. But I also don't think I can start with a number. Although it's F sharp, so you never know. Let's see what it says. Not valid. Suppose I could do N first. why it doesn't let me rename. I've got no idea. I'll just have to do this one by one. Nope. Okay, that looks a little nicer. Have the that lined up. I want to keep my old code, just so anyone reading it can say, okay, this is how I tried originally before. This is not how I would usually code anything, but it's to give it that feel of the song, like it said it could in the instructions. I'm commenting some more tests up that didn't save. Okay, 15. Zero skipped. That's good. The only thing I'm disappointed in is this parameter array. I might have a little more looking into that, but I'm doubtful I will figure that out. I hope you enjoyed watching. I think it ended up being quite a long one. But I kind of enjoyed coding it. I'm interested to see what other people have done. You can also have a look there. Anyway, thank you very much for watching. See you next time. Bye-bye.